So a lot of our listeners are sitting there, they can't find anything on the MLS. It's super competitive.
Right.
And you're sitting here saying, hey, I'm taking down 700 properties I need investors for. That sounds great. If I'm an investor, how can I engage with the land bank? What is step number one now that I'm aware?
Step number one is go to our website. So it's CookCountyLandBank.org, CookCountyLandBank.org, or just Google Cook County Land Bank Authority, and we'll be the first thing that pops up. But you go to our website, there's a tab there that says apply/buy property. You go to that tab, it directs you to our interactive property viewer. That's our fancy word for map. And then once you get to that page, that landing page, you can say view all properties. This takes you to a map of the county with the outline of the city of Chicago, and you see a bunch of colored dots. Orange are for residential, red is for commercial, purple is for industrial, green is for vacant land. And it's a Google map. You can zoom in and you can zoom out. We also have a filter button at the top, so you can filter by neighborhood, you can filter by inventory type. But however you do it, you find a property that you're interested in, or find a group of properties that you're interested in. As you click any of those dots, what explodes out is a picture of the property. And if you click that, it'll take you to a picture of the property, the PIN number, short description. They give you a deadline for when applications are due. And there's a button there that says apply for this property. And that's the key. So you can put the application on that property. And I tell everyone, if you think you're interested, apply for the property. Applying for the property does two things. One, it logs your interest in the property. So as we move forward, you'll get any communication about that property. But two, it also gives you access to the property. So if it's a house, then we give you the code so you'll be able to go in and access the property. And this is important. We don't sell things sight unseen. We want you to go into the property and see it. It's distressed, but my idea of distress and your idea of distress is different. I want you to see the property for yourself. I want you to take pictures. I want you to take measurements. I want you to take your contractors, your architect, whoever can go in and help you to assess exactly what needs to be done. You put the initial application in. We contact you around what your next steps are. But as you're putting in your offer application, we want you to make an informed choice around if this is something you want to do. And part of the offer application is to let us know exactly what's your scope of work, what's your budget, and how you intend to pay for it.
Got it.
So that's the website.
So if I'm on the website and I see something for $50,000,
right,
and I go, okay, that might work. By clicking on that and applying, I'm not giving you an offer at $50,000. I'm just putting my name, my hat in the ring so I can go see the property and then potentially fill out the application, say, hey, I can offer you 40, 60, whatever the number is.
That's correct. So, right. So when you go to apply, you're not applying for 50. You're not putting in an offer for 50. You're expressing interest in the property so you can go see it. In fact, if you go in to try and put it in an offer and you haven't seen it, your offer will be rejected. We want you to see the property. I got to know that you had a chance to see the property and that you're putting in an offer based on your inspection of the property so you can make an informed bid and informed choice about what you're trying to do. But that's exactly right. The application doesn't cost you anything and it doesn't obligate you. So you can put in multiple applications for properties that you may be interested in seeing. And you can even put in multiple offers in for properties. Then we'll make a decision. If let's say there's 10 properties that you put in initial application on, you get the access code, you go see all 10 properties. Of the 10, you decide, hey, I want to apply for 5. These are 5 that I can make work. You put the application in. As it comes back to us, and we know that you're the same person applying for these properties, you know, we may make a decision to sell you 1, 2, or 3. I'm probably not going to sell all 5 to you, at least if you're, you know, new to us. We still like to date before we get married, right? We still like to get the chance to know you before we just jump in and start selling that many properties. But do so because it lets us know what your interest is, lets us know what your geographic preference are, the housing, you know, in terms of the pricing and the scopes of work. It helps us to really understand who you are. So I encourage you to do that, and then we'll take it from there.